and welcome to Britt Arnhild's World here on YouTube. I am Britt Arnhild and I'm coming to you from the middle of Norway, from the city of Trondheim. I hope you enjoyed the film in the beginning here with the Nordic lights, the Aurora Borealis. It was filmed last month, I think it was. Maybe it was even the end of September. I can't quite remember. And I took it actually from the veranda, the terrace outside our kitchen. And I'm so pleased that I managed with my cell phone to do this filming. Obviously, we are living in a place where there are a lot of electric lights, indoors, outdoors. All these city lights, you know, even though we live on the outskirts of the city, there are still street lights and from all the houses and everything. And then, of course, it's hard to see the Nordic lights. But it was a dark night. It was cold. The sky was completely clear with no skies, with no clouds, a lot of stars. And I was able to do this filming. I have been saving it for this special episode. So I hope you enjoyed it. It is, I was about to say it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, but it isn't. Christmas for me starts on the 24th or actually the 23rd of December. The whole of December before that is Advent. Leading up to Christmas, a period of preparations. And still, we have not started Advent, so still it's only November. It's completely dark in the night, the days are short. I really don't like November much. It's such a dark and dreary month, I think. But we have reached the middle top now, so we are rolling down towards December. I'm sitting up in my studio tonight filming, and I'm very sorry about the light. It can even look like sun rays here, but there are spotlights up in the roof. And I have the window right in front of me, looking out into the walled garden. And it's completely dark outside, so it's only artificial light in here. And it's not the best light, but that was what I could do this time. It has been some busy days and I haven't had the possibility to do filming during daylight down in the living room. And as we are approaching Advent, and I plan, as I did last year, to make one Advent episode every day from December 1st until December 24th. I plan to do it up here, maybe not exactly this angel. It might be from a corner over there where I also did most of the filming last year. But then you have to do with all this artificial light, electric light. So my hair look like silver, doesn't it? It's of course the well, I have gray hair, almost white, but the spotlights up in the roof make it gives it a silvery look. I am going to talk to you today about something I knitted years ago. It is a mitten. It is a green mitten. And it's just one mitten. It's some green loopy yarn I got from Iceland years and years and years ago. When the children were small, I got a huge box of this green yarn from my sister-in-law, which is Icelandic. And I made this pattern with the Latvian braid and these stripes, and I knitted this green mitten. And it has a very special story. I love to knit things for the grandchildren, and I used to love to knit for the children. And since I knit a lot, one of my daughters knit a lot, my daughter-in-law knits a lot. There will be enough sweaters and everything, knitted items they need. So I have to come up with some new ideas. which I love to do. You have already heard about the snails and the snail tales, which I'm making. I have finished the book, the picture book I have made for the grandchildren now. It will be a surprise for them for Christmas, with the first tales from the snail family. I have sent the first, what do you call it? I've sent it to the company who make these books. The first book, which is a kind of... I'm searching for the English name again, but it's a kind of trying. So I hope to get this first book back next week. And then I will look through it and see if everything is all right, if I'm satisfied. And then I will make an order for the grandchildren. And in the end of this video, I have made some footage. I have collected footage from many of my snail tales. So you will enjoy them together with my mother's music, as usual. It was also my mother playing in the start of this video, of course. But back to this mitten. I think that most of, at least you Americans, maybe English also, and other countries, know this book, The Mitten by Jan Brett. This is an American book for children, based on, actually, I think it is an Ukrainian folk tale, which a Norwegian late author retold in this little book, the fur mitten, he called it. It tells here that it's based on a Ukrainian folk tale, the fur mitten. And it is a lovely tale about a boy who loses his mitten in the forest. And a lot of animals come in to stay inside the mitten to get warmth during the very cold winter's night. It's a very cute tale, and it's told in different ways. This is, as I said, by a Norwegian writer, Alf Prøysen, who used to be very famous here in Norway. He still is. He has made, the English name. I know he has been translated into English, and it's about this woman, this lady, who was transformed into a little teaspoon lady. Mrs. Pepperpot, is that what you call her? Or is that something else? I can't quite remember. But there are a lot of books about this woman, and they are very cute. And then this by Jan Brett is kind of a similar story, but it differs in many ways. But then I think after Alf Prøysen had made this book, he made a longer tale about the green mitten, den grønne votten, the green mitten. And here you see there is a little boy. His grandmother has knitted a pair of green mittens for him. And he loves the mittens, and he goes out to play in the snow. And he's very unfortunate. He loses one of the mittens, and then a mice finds it and move in there. So when I was 20 years old, I worked for a year as a kind of internship in a kindergarten. And the main teacher there, she was very creative. It was a small kindergarten. There were two kind of grown-ups, educated teachers. And then it was me, and it was another young woman who came there to work with them. And this main teacher, she was, as I said, very creative. And she made me and the other young woman working there make a lot of stuff for the kindergarten, for the children to play with. And she made me make a mitten. I remember I knitted one. It was given to the kindergarten. And then I had to draw all these animals which you meet in this story. I had to draw them on cardboard, and I think I'm not quite sure if I remember correct, but I think I glued a stick to them so I could play with them. And then I could play or act the tale of the green mitten for the children. And I never forgot that. So when my children were small, especially when the boys were small, I remember I knitted a green mitten and I knitted a little mice family to move into the mitten. And that's what I have done to our grandchildren now. You have the family here. It's hard to see in the light. Yeah, there you see. One of them is a daddy. There is a mother. There are the children. And I'm looking down here in the box because I used these same mittens last year to knit the figures of a Christmas song, which was made also by this Alf Preussen. It's called the Mouse Song, Musevisa in Norwegian. And it's such a funny tale. It's about a mouse family, and the father, the mother, they ask the children to be careful not to be taken by the mouse trap, and if they are not, they will celebrate Christmas and even celebrate Christmas the year, the next year. And they make in the tale, in the song, they make they don't have a Christmas tree, but they have an old boot with this cork as a star, and there is an old grandma rocking in her rocking chair, which is an old potato. So I made this whole story for the children, for the grandchildren last year. And then I used the mice again. I reused them, you can say. So I have two tales actually with them, the green mitten and this mouse Christmas song. So I wanted to show them to you today. They came up to me as a remembrance, I think it was yesterday, because on YouTube, I can follow to see how many people who are watching the special episodes. And the second episode in 2019, it was in January, which is almost 3 years ago now. I had recently knitted this green mitten then, and I made an episode about it. And somehow this episode has been very popular over the last couple of days. So I went back there and I can see it has had thousands of viewers. And I thought, oh, I want to tell the tale about the green mitten again for my English viewers, because that episode 3 years ago was in Norwegian only. And I also thought that I will read you the tale, the Jan Brett tale. It might be some copyright here, but I hope it's okay. I'm giving the credit, of course, to Jan Brett, who has, I think she has both written the tale and done the drawings, the paintings. And on the cover page here, it says, with special thanks to my Ukrainian friend, Oksana Piasecki. So she has also based it on this Ukrainian folk tale. So, do you want to hear the tale? Once there was a boy, I can try to do it like this. Once there was a boy named Nicky. He wanted mittens as white as snow. So this book needs a white mitten. Mine is green. If you drop a white mitten in the snow, it will be hard to find, his grandmother told him. But Nicky wanted snow white mittens so much that Baba made them for him. When she finished knitting, Nicky put on the mittens and went out to play. It wasn't long before one mitten fell off. A little mole found it and crawled inside. It was just the right size, so he decided to stay. A rabbit came hopping by. He wiggled in next to the mole. A hedgehog wanted to get warm, the mole and the rabbit made room for him. Oops. The owl didn't want to be left out, so the mole, the rabbit and the hedgehog had to move over. The little mitten was getting crowded. A badger looked out of his house and saw the mitten. He climbed right in. It started to snow, so a fox pushed his way in and made himself right at home. Then a big bear sniffed at the mitten. The animals were packed in tight, but the bear didn't care. He crawled in anyway. The mitten was getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Then a tiny mouse squeezed in and perched herself in the big bear's nose. The mouse whiskers tickled the bear's nose. Achoo! The bear sneezed. All the animals flew out of the mitten. Nicky saw his mitten sail up in the air. From the window, Baba watched Nicky catch his mitten. "See, Baba," he called to her, "I have both my mittens." And Baba smiled. A very cute story, isn't it? I think it's time now to start reading it to the grandchildren again. I remember I read it a lot last winter. And we are waiting for the first snow now. I was hoping to get some yesterday, but now it's milder, so we have to wait a little. Okay, thank you very much for this episode. Next week there will be a Norwegian one, but probably with a lot of footage, which might be interesting for you as well. And then after that, it's time to start the daily Advent episodes. I really hope to see you then. And I would also love to get comments from you and likes from you. It really does a lot to my pleasure of making these videos. Goodbye for now. I hope the light isn't too bad. And I'll see you next week and the week after. Bye.